Good day. I'm Dennis Miller from the Montgomery County Office of Veteran Affairs. Welcome to our May 2021 monthly video update. Got a couple of goals here. This is our second one, but our first goal is that we're going to try to do this the first week of every month. We're going to try to keep it to 5 minutes long. My apologies, we didn't do that last month. And we're going to try to keep you informed. If you see this clip on our website and it's been over a month, don't panic. It just means that we got overrun with regular work, and we'll update it as we need to. General statement, the Office of Veteran Affairs is here for the veteran community for advocacy, access to services, processing federal, state, and local claims, and operating the free veteran shuttle. What are we going to talk about this month? We're going to talk about Memorial Day. There's a lot going on for Memorial Day. But first, we have other observances. Memorial Day is not until the 31st. There's a couple of other things going on. First is, the 1st of May, Silver Star Service Day for recipients of the Silver Star. We have a lot in Montgomery County. On the 7th of May, it's Military Spouses Day. VE Day, Victory in Europe, is the 8th of May. And Armed Forces Day is right halfway through the month. The Ides of May, if you will, the 15th of May. And like I said, Memorial Day on the 31st. Now, it's interesting, and I want to clear something up right now. Memorial Day is about veterans of the past. Veterans Day is about veterans of the present. But you can celebrate both of that this month because the 15th of May is Armed Forces Day and the 31st is Memorial Day. Another thing to clear up, it's not necessarily the right thing to say when you say Happy Memorial Day. It's a day of remembrance. It's a day of remembrance for our family members and our fellow brothers and sisters in arms that have passed before us. Maybe something more along the lines of have a peaceful Memorial Day, because you don't know what people are going through. I do want you to get involved still. We are placing 59,000 flags on veteran graves. Now, when I say we, I don't mean my office. We have partnerships with 60 organizations that are doing that for us and for their fallen brothers and sisters in arms. We have a cemetery map on montcopa.org/266. That's our veterans website. Click on cemetery map. It's going to bring you to a GIS map. You click on the blue dot, which is a cemetery closest to your house. Cemetery caretaker information will come up. Contact them. Ask them when they're doing flag placement. Tell them you want to get involved. Most flag placements are done 2 weeks or 3 weeks before Memorial Day. So something along the lines of the 14th to the 15th or the weekend after, maybe the weekend of Memorial Day, but that's generally if there's like a rain date or something like that. But I want you to give that a try. Now, with all the graves that we have in Montgomery County, what if your loved one or your relative gets missed? That happens. There's a lot of graves out there. We have volunteer organizations doing it, Boy Scouts, Girl Scouts, different high schools, a lot of different organizations, and sometimes they miss them. But if they have one of these or one like it, they're not going to miss them. This is a flag holder. They are free from the Montgomery County Commissioners. This is a generic one. It just says veteran on it. But generally, flag holders have to do with a period of service that the veteran served. The American Revolutionary War, the Civil War, World War I, World War II. If you're not sure of the dates of when your relative served, well, that's on our website too, right on the opening page. But how do you get one of these? You may ask, how do you get one of these? Okay, good. I imagine that you asked on your own. You go to our website, you ask for a flag holder. We ask for some information, mainly where the veteran is buried. And you could pick it up for free. When we tell you to pick it up for free, downstairs at the Human Services Center, 1430 DeKalb in Norristown. Or if we need to, we can make other arrangements. I still want you to get involved even more. Check out social media for VFW, American Legion, and other organizations like Team Red, White, and Blue for veteran-centric events. Check out the Chapel of the Four Chaplains website. Actually, you should check out the chapel anyway. They're down in Philly at the Navy Yard. If you say that you've been there before, I'm telling you that you haven't, because last year they redid the whole place and it looks fantastic. But they have a plethora, that's a military word, of different events throughout the week, orienteering different celebrations for Armed Forces Week. And a lot of these events that I'm telling you about, they're all kind of fun related, but there's other meetings where you can go get help. For example, Veterans in Recovery meets every Wednesday at the St. James Episcopal Church in Collegeville at 19:30 hours. So if you need help, suicidal ideation, danger or relapse, or you're in some kind of trouble, Veterans in Recovery could be a really good group for you. The Springford area is looking for names of veterans of the past because they want to put together a Spring Forward Veterans Memorial. If you have that information, call Pinky, Bill Pinkerton, great guy, 610-332-3130. This is also on his Facebook site where he's looking to get the information for putting that together. Other than that, I want to give you a really good thank you. I want to let you know that no one works alone. We are deeply grateful to the veteran organizations we work with every single month. There isn't enough time to name them all. We're here for you. We've always been here for you. Remember that we triage our work. So when you call us, we may not get to you first. To add events or to this monthly video update or to have comments, teamveterans@montcopa.org. is the best way. That's our general email. And if you want to contact our office, once again, 610-213-4022. The general number that ends in 3285, we don't want you to call that. We want you to call 610-213-4022. That's a cell phone. Sometimes you have to leave a voicemail, but generally a live person is going to pick up the phone because we want to meet your needs as soon as possible. Other than that, I'll see you next month. Thank you.